You're going to be shocked by what you see in this 14-minute video. Now, I'm only going to play a few minutes of it to let you know what's being said all throughout the video. And you got to know, for it to get to this point means they've been working on this for decades. Check this out.
When I was doing research a number of years ago for my book, Killer Fish, I was stunned when they looked at the 250 most pristine waters in the world, notably in the North and South Pole, people not living, any marginal amounts of people living there. And every bit of the water had pharmaceutical drugs in it.
Do you know what's in your drinking water? A shocking Associated Press investigation found various pharmaceuticals in the drinking supplies of at least 41 million Americans. Tainted water was found from New Jersey to California.
The question that right now is on everyone's mind is, how in the world did drugs get into our drinking water?
New worries tonight about the safety of America's water supply. In the first nationwide investigation of its kind, the Associated Press found that at least 41 million of us are drinking water that contains traces of prescription drugs. And now many are wondering, is our water safe?
Really, whether you need it or not, it's a virtual medicine cabinet in your tap water if you live in many, many areas across the country. There's a scary new report out today. The Associated Press did a big amount of research on this, and the findings show that there were traces of prescription drugs in the water supply used by 41 million Americans in some of the biggest cities in the U.S. The list includes over-the-counter pain medication, mood stabilizers, even hormones.
The United Nations estimates close to 1.5 billion people around the world do not have access to clean drinking water. What about here in the United States? Antiepileptics were found in drinking water of Southern California. A sex hormone was found in San Francisco's water. Three medications and an antibiotic were found in the water supply of Tucson, Arizona. And a mood stabilizer was found in the water of New Jersey. And that's just to name a few. The Associated Press has conducted an extensive investigation into the drinking water in at least 24 major American cities across the country, which contain trace amounts of a wide array of pharmaceuticals. The amounts might be small, but scientists are worried about the long-term health and environmental consequences of their presence in the water supplies of some 41 million Americans. The five-month investigation of 62 metropolitan areas and 51 smaller cities found many drinking water suppliers, including bottled water companies, do not even test for the presence of drugs in the water. The utilities that do test for drugs often don't tell customers about the trace amounts of medications in their water.
Pretty wide range. Here's the drinking water in Washington, D.C. They found six pharmaceuticals in our drinking water here. They include ibuprofen, caffeine, monacin, and about three or four others. In Philadelphia, they had 56 pharmaceuticals or byproducts. They range everything from epilepsy medication to mental health medicines to pharmaceuticals that really run the gamut.
Now, I am sure that every student of prophecy not only knows how this was prophesied, we also know it's not just in the water. It's also in the air we breathe, thanks to the chemtrails everyone sees with their own eyes every single day. And no, those aren't contrails, as the government keeps claiming. Contrails disappear after a few moments as the sunlight dissipates them naturally. Chemtrails not only become massive clouds filled with strange chemicals and dangerous minerals that eventually waft down on everyone below, sometimes, for reasons I am yet unclear about, these same clouds or chemtrails also fall down much quicker to Earth at times, and they look like cobwebs all over the place outside. I've seen it happen on my own land at least twice, as I recall. And when they say 40 million Americans are affected in the video, no, that number has to be much higher. The fact they found pharmaceuticals in the waters all around the North and South Poles, wherein not a lot of people are known to reside there, as we all know, a nation with nearly 400 million people in it would have a much higher dose rate in the water. That's just common sense. And by the way, when you live outside the city like I do, where you can rely on well water, which is filtered through sometimes hundreds of feet of earth, you can actually see the chemtrails that are sprayed above your home, and they do it in such a way so as to allow them to float over as they begin to grow as clouds, they float over and then rain down on the cities that are anywhere from 50 to 100 miles away from where you are out in the middle of nowhere. You can actually watch the trails become clouds and then head towards the city. You know, just one more reason to get out of the cities. But how was this all prophesied? Well, notice what it says in Revelation when speaking of one of many of the future global sins of the Vatican. It says in Revelation 18, verse 23, that by thy sorceries were all nations deceived. And what does the word sorcery translate to? That's right. The word sorcery comes from the word pharmakia, of which our modern-day word pharmacy comes from. And how can we verify for a fact that they're behind this? Well, have you seen this page on my website that I posted back in 2012? You know, students of prophecy knew all about this on day one because we studied the word daily. And in so doing, our Father in heaven blesses us with eyes that see. But it wasn't until the Vatican was dragged into court for using their big pharma institution to commit crimes against humanity that it became very easy to show some that Christian prophecy is that accurate. Thank you for watching. God bless.